Welcome back to Tef's Travels, everyone. Today we're going to be fixing a problem with the ABS on the Volvo XC70. On the dashboard, you can see we've got four messages there. We've got the master warning triangle, and we've got the ABS brake warning illuminated in the corner there on that display. Now, at this point, you might be wondering how I know it's the right-hand wheel to remove and check the ABS ring on. Well, fortunately, I've got a system called VIDA, which is Volvo's own workshop IT system, and it allows you to plug a computer with the software package loaded onto it into the car's OBD2 port, and it tells you exactly what's going on. I don't think you can get this level of detail or anything like it from any of the generic OBD2 readers. So VIDA is something I would definitely recommend investing in. Alternatively, if you go on eBay, you can see people selling VIDA code reads for about 40 quid. That comes in very handy as well if you've got a really sticky problem that you need to work out. Because if you go to a main Volvo Steeler, that will cost you £90 plus VAT. And looking at this system here, that told me exactly where to go. It was a right-hand road wheel, so I took that off. If you don't know which one of the two front wheels it is, you can take both off, remove each ABS sensor in turn, and look down at the ABS ring to see if it's cracked. And I'll now show you how to do that. Okay, so I've got the wheel off. I'm not going to show you how to do that, as I'm sure you all know. The first thing we are going to do is remove the ABS sensor, which is attached to this cable here. And it's held on by that bolt down there, which is an 8mm bolt. We're going to remove that and just wiggle out the sensor itself. That gives us access to look down there into where the ABS ring is, and we should be able to have a look for any cracks. So we just get out 8mm socket and finish removing that bolt. Remove it, put that somewhere safe, and then we should be able to just wiggle out the sensor like that. Now, the state of the sensor itself will tell us a bit. This one, you can see it's rubbed on the bottom there. That suggests that there's something touching it, and usually that means that part of the ABS ring itself has come loose, and one edge of it is higher than the other, and it's dragging along there. Let's see if we can see down that hole and get a bit more light in there perhaps, so we can see what we're doing. So that's the hole we're trying to look down. You can see the ABS ring there, which is that sort of castellated thing. And I'm going to turn the wheel using the brake disc. Not with the other foam resting on it, that's not going to work, is it? So you might be able to see down that hole, you can see a crack in the ABS ring there between two castellations, and both of those are shiny, which means they've been rubbing against something. So that's enough for me to confirm that this is worth doing. So now let's get the this assembly off. So that means removing these two bolts here, and then removing the drive shaft nut in the middle of the hub, and then this whole assembly can sort of drop down out of the way. So let's get these off first. Okay, so I finally got those nuts off the end of those two bolts there. That was not easy. Using the cheap Chinese torque wrench, impact driver, wasn't enough. Eventually I had to put a ratchet, a T-bar, and this huge pole on the end of the ratchet just to get it moving. Eventually I did, and now they're off. So what I'm going to use now is a small hammer to knock those through. Before I take them out any further, I'm going to put a prop stand underneath here with a bit of wood to stop that falling and damaging. Okay, so now we've got all this released, you can see the drive shaft here and the ABS ring just on here, and the split is very, very obvious indeed, and in fact you can sort of move it just with your fingers, and it's even more pronounced if you get a screwdriver and sort of wiggle it about. So that will not take much coming off. I'm just going to bang it with a hammer and split it and let it fall down. The other problem is that seal came off and it's in here, and you can see by the amount of rust that when that caliper seized up back a few months ago, that it's obviously cooked a lot of stuff and quite possibly is the root cause of this problem here. So I'm gonna have a clean up in here, pack this full of grease, and get another seal, probably, or maybe not. Okay, let's just give that a tap. I literally just gave that a couple of taps on the hammer and it's already off that far. So that was well and truly broken. It's now resting the bottom of the drive shaft on the other edge, and that just came off basically in my hands. So there is one fully busted up ABS ring, and that's it dropping to the floor. And then we can have a look at this surface here, and there's a bit of pitting, bit of rust as expected, but that will clean up. So I'm gonna get some emery paper, some sandpaper, clean that up a bit, and offer up the new ring to see how well or otherwise that goes on it, and fully expecting to have to get a blowtorch out and heat it up. But I'll bring you back once I've had a bit of a scrape around at this rust here. Okay, so that's the mating surface here, cleaned up simply with a wire brush. It's a lot better than it was. It's not perfect, but it is better. And you can see hopefully around there there's a bit of pitting, but I think this will go on. And even if it doesn't and it fails and wastes, you know, this is wasted like, you know, 20 quid total parts. And ultimately this car has done 208,000 miles, so it doesn't owe me anything. What I'm going to do now is just try and tap this on, because it feels relatively close. It feels like you could tap on all the way around, so I'm going to try that. But fully in the expectation that I'm going to have to take it off and use a bit of heat. So I'm just going to tap a little bit around each edge, and see how far we get with that. Okay, that ring is now on all the way around. I just tapped it with a small hammer. A genuinely small hammer this time, and then rotated the drive shaft, and now it's home all the way around. Good way to check is to try and get a screwdriver in one place and then try and get it another place, see if you get any different amount of wiggle, and you get the same all the way around, and you can see this sort of beveled edge here. So I'm confident that is on. I'm going to grease up and put it all back together. Okay, so I've got the strut back into the knuckle, which was extremely difficult, I have to say. Maneuvering the strut around like that when it wanted to twist in every direction was very hard indeed. I think it would have been easier if I'd been able to undo this and swing this out of the way, but I couldn't. That instead just rotated, so that's probably broken inside there, which will cause us problems, no doubt. It's also pretty dangerous to do this. I had to loosen off this. I didn't want to remove that completely because then the strut would drop down and be too low, but it's back in. I'm going to put these nuts on, torque them up, get the caliper back on, and what I'm minded to do is just try and see if it will function properly with this ABS sensor, because that's the easier option than feeding the new one through there. If it doesn't work, then I will replace it, of course. Let's see how it goes. All right, let's just get the last torquing done and we'll give it a test drive. Click. That's close enough. Okay, let's see how we've done. So the ignition is on. We do not have a master alarm. We do not have an ABS light. I have taken this for a test drive. It runs just fine and drives just fine. We've got two messages, time for regular service, and dipped bulb failure, dipped beam. Nothing about a ABS fault, nothing about traction control or brake system service required, and the master alarm is gone, and the down here the ABS warning light is gone. So that seems to have worked. All we did then was just replace this broken ABS ring, and that was relatively straightforward, and for a grand total cost of £8. So it's a job I can highly recommend, and when you get round to it, if you excuse the pun, I hope you have it as easy as I did. Thanks for watching, and good luck.